Good evening, friends. Today we are going to discuss about the layout of a hydroelectric plant. So basically, power plants are classified into three different categories: thermal power plants, hydel power plants, and nuclear power plants. So if a steam turbine is used for operating the power plant, it is referred to as a thermal power plant. And similarly, if water turbine is used for power generation, it is called as a hydel power plant. So now we are going to discuss study the various components of hydroelectric power plant, so also called as hydel power plants. Now we can see the various components of the hydel power plant or hydroelectric power plant in this slide. So basically, the first one, it is called as a head race. That means a reservoir is formed on the left hand side of the dam at a higher level for supplying water onto the blades of the turbine. So this is called as head race. And generally, the level of water in this reservoir, it is called as full reservoir level. So one reservoir is needed for supplying water onto the blades of the turbine, and it is formed on the left hand side of the dam at a higher level, and it is called as a head race or supply reservoir. And secondly, one more reservoir is formed at a lower level for receiving the entire quantity of water that is coming out of the turbine, and this is called as tail race. So first reservoir formed at a higher level on the left hand side of the dam, and second reservoir formed at a lower level below the turbine. So these reservoirs are very, very essential for doing hydroelectric power generation. The first reservoir for supplying water onto the blades of the turbine, and second reservoir for receiving the entire quantity of water that is coming out of the turbine. So that means the turbine will not be using the quantity of water. So it will be only using the energy that is present in the liquid. So it will not be consuming the quantity of liquid. So therefore, the entire quantity of water supplied onto the turbine will be coming out of the turbine. So therefore, one reservoir is essential for supplying water onto the turbine, and the second reservoir very, very essential for receiving the total quantity of water that is coming out of the turbine. So these are the basic components of this hydroelectric power plant. And secondly, we can see the arrangement of the dam. So dam is a hydraulic structure. It is built across the river in perpendicular direction. So it is used for preventing the flow of river water, so that this river water can be stored in the first reservoir. So dam is a very, very important component, major component of this power plant for preventing the flow of water, so that it can be, so that the water can be stored in the first reservoir. Now, these dams, they are used for power generation, they are used for, irrigation, they are used for controlling of flood waters, they are used for, can be used for supplying water for industries, that is for operating boilers in process industries. So several benefits are derived by constructing these dams. So therefore, these all the dams are referred to as multi-purpose projects. Used for power generation, used for irrigation, used for flood control, used for industrial water. So therefore, they are called as multi-purpose projects. Several dams are built across India on several rivers. So as a whole, this dam is a very, very essential component for doing power generation, and therefore it is referred to as a multi-purpose project. And next, we can see a pipeline that's called as a penstock. In the figure, we can see the arrangement of the pipeline that is called as a penstock. And this pipeline is used for conveying or for supplying water from the first reservoir onto the blades of the reservoir. So therefore, the inlet of the pipeline is fixed in the surface of the dam, and that is well below the water level in the first reservoir. And secondly, the outlet of the pipeline is exposed to the blades of the turbine or blades of the runner. So therefore, with this arrangement, this pipeline can be used for supplying water from the first reservoir onto the blades of the runner for doing power generation. So this is, another important component. And finally, we have to control the quantity of water that is entering the turbine according to the load acting on the turbine. So when the load on the turbine decreases, we have to supply less quantity of water. When the load on the turbine increases, we have to supply more quantity of water. So therefore, a chamber is fitted as an auxiliary arrangement. A chamber is fitted to the pipeline that is called as surge tank or surge chamber. So when the load on the turbine increases, it will be supplying, the surge chamber will be supplying extra water, extra quantity of water, or additional quantity of water into the pipeline and or into the turbine. And when the load on the turbine decreases, it will be receiving unwanted quantity of water that is rejected by the turbine. So this fitting of this chamber to the pipeline is very, very essential for controlling the effects of water hammer and cavitation. So if you do not provide, this is not shown in this figure, but it is very, very essential for power generation. And if you do not, fit this chamber, it is very difficult to control the effect of cavitation and also the effect of water hammer in the pipeline. So this is, another important element that is very, very essential for operating the power plant. And finally, now you can see the arrangement of the Pelton turbine. In this figure, Pelton turbine is shown for doing, power generation. So therefore, a nozzle is fitted to the outlet of the penstock. So this item is fitted to the outlet of the penstock for raising the kinetic energy of the liquid. So we can see the arrangement of the nozzle that is fitted to the outlet of the penstock. And finally, you can see the arrangement of the turbine, and this is the Pelton turbine is shown in this figure. So the shaft of the turbine will be arranged in horizontal direction. So therefore, the shaft of the generator must be also arranged in horizontal direction. So therefore, the generator will be coming behind the turbine, and that is not shown in this particular, it is not visible in this view of this. So when water is striking the blades of the turbine, blades of the runner, turbine will be converting the kinetic energy of the liquid into mechanical energy of the shaft. And finally, the generator will be converting the mechanical energy of the shaft into electrical energy. So nozzle is converting pressure energy into kinetic energy, turbine is converting kinetic energy into mechanical energy, and ultimately generator is converting mechanical energy into electrical energy. So because this is a Pelton turbine, this it's not possible to indicate the generator which is placed behind the turbine. So now for this purpose, a building is constructed at the foot of the dam that is called as a powerhouse. So this building is very, very essential for housing the assemblies of a turbine and generator. So basically it is used for housing the turbine and generator. So we have to construct a building at the foot of the dam for this purpose. This is called as a powerhouse. So this powerhouse is a very, very another major component of this Heidel plant. So as indicated just now, this powerhouse is used for housing or accommodating turbine and generator that is used for power generation. So these are the various components of the Heidel plant. So that is engaged, using a Pelton. And finally, this pressure of the liquid here in the case of a Pelton turbine, the pressure of the liquid that is coming out of the runner will be equivalent to atmospheric pressure. So no negative pressure is developed while operating the Pelton turbine. So therefore, a draft tube, we need not use a draft tube. A draft tube is not required for operating the Pelton turbine. So therefore, it is not shown in this particular. So friends, this is the arrangement of a hydel plant using Pelton turbine for generating power. So I would like to show this another figure. So this is the figure, this is the figure indicating the power plant with usage of either Francis or Kaplan turbine. So this is the power plant. The earlier slide indicates the power plant, used with a Pelton turbine. And this is the power plant used with either Francis turbine or Kaplan turbine. So here the difference is, in the case of a Pelton turbine, the shafts are arranged in horizontal direction, so therefore the generator will be coming behind the Pelton turbine. But whereas in the case of Francis and Kaplan turbines, the shaft must be arranged in vertical position. So therefore, the generator will be coming, will be placed above the turbine. So this is shown in this figure. So you can see the arrangement of a turbine at a lower level and the arrangement of a generator at a higher level. So for operating Pelton turbine, generator and the turbine will be placed in the same level, or in other words, generator will be placed behind the Pelton turbine. But in the case of Francis and Kaplan turbines, it has to be placed above the turbine. So we can make out the difference between these two diagrams. And secondly, this water that is coming out of the Francis and Kaplan turbines will be having negative pressure. So negative pressure is not developed in Pelton turbine, so we need not use a draft tube. So, but whereas here negative pressure is developed in the case of Francis and Kaplan turbines, therefore, a pipeline is fitted to the outlet of the runner. So that is called as a draft tube. So this draft tube will be receiving the entire quantity of water that is coming out of the turbine, and it will be raising the pressure energy of the liquid. That means it will be removing the negative pressure of the liquid. And of course, finally, it will be discharging the entire quantity of water onto the tailpipes. So draft tubes are not arranged as shown in the first diagram. Draft tubes are not required for operating Pelton turbines. But whereas in the case of Francis and Kaplan turbines, negative pressure will be developed at the outlet of the runner. So therefore, we have to make arrangements for removing the negative pressure of the liquid. So for this purpose, a draft tube is fitted to the outlet of the runner. So it will be receiving the quantity of water. It will be receiving the liquid that is coming out of the runner. It will be removing the negative pressure of the liquid. And finally, it will be discharging the entire quantity of water onto the tail rays. So that is the difference between these two arrangements. So the first arrangement, engaging a Pelton turbine for power generation. And in the second arrangement, we are arranging either Francis turbine or the Kaplan turbine for power generation. So these are the various components, and This is the general arrangement of the hydroelectric power plant. Now let us make a quick review of these various components of the power plant, which we have discussed just now. And we are making a review of this item. The first one called as head race, a reservoir formed at a higher level for storing water. And the water stored in this reservoir is used, is supplied onto the blades of the runner for power generation. So, levels, apart from this, levels are also shown in this slide. Normal level of water, that's called as full reservoir level. Lowest level referred to as minimum water level. And the highest level is referred to as maximum water level. So as a whole, this is the first reservoir, very, very essential, as told earlier. The first reservoir, very, very essential for supplying, for storing water, and also for supplying water onto the blades of the runner for power generation. As a second component, this is the tail race. So as told earlier, one more reservoir has to be formed at a lower level. This is referred to as a tail race. And this tail race will be receiving, it is used for receiving the entire quantity of water that is coming out of the turbine. So first reservoir for supplying water onto the turbine, and this second reservoir for receiving the quantity of water, entire quantity of water that is coming out of the turbine. So these are the uses of these two reservoirs. Very, very essential. Two reservoirs, very, very essential. One for supplying water, and second reservoir for receiving water coming out of the turbine. And these levels of water, we have talked about levels of water. So this is the level of water in the tail race. This is referred to as a tail water level. It's referred to as tail water level. So level of water in the first reservoir called as full reservoir level. The level of water in the second reservoir, it is referred to as a tail water level. And similarly, as mentioned earlier, the turbine will be taking only the energy that is present in the liquid. It will not be using, it will not be absorbing the quantity of liquid. So the entire quantity of water that's entering the turbine will be coming out of the turbine. So for this purpose, we are using this reservoir. So it is referred to as a tail race. So as indicated earlier, so this is the dam is the vital component of the power plant. So it is built across the river for preventing the flow of water and also for storing water in the first reservoir. And of course, it is divided into two components. The first one called as overflow dam for letting off excess water into the downstream. And the second one is called as non-overflow dam. So this is useful for doing power generation. Yes, this is the penstock. We have talked about the penstock. So this is fixed in the surface of the dam. It is conveying water from the first reservoir into the onto the blades of the runner. And a gate is fixed at the inlet of the penstock. That's called as a sluice gate. And a gantry crane is arranged at the top of the dam. And this is used for opening the gates of the penstock. So single pane is sufficient for opening, you know, all the gates of the penstock. So this is about the arrangement of the penstock. So surge tank, we have discussed about the surge tank. It's a chamber, vertical chamber, fitted to the top of the penstock, called as surge chamber. So it will be receiving excess water, and also it will be supplying extra water into the turbine according to the load acting on the turbine. So as I mentioned earlier, this surge tank is very, very essential for controlling the problems of water hammer, for controlling the, and also for controlling the problems of cavitation. So next one is a powerhouse, a building that is constructed at the foot of the dam. So it's, as already explained, it is used for housing a turbine and a generator. So in the case of a Pelton turbine, a generator is placed behind the turbine. And in the case of Francis and Kaplan turbine, the generator has to be placed above the. So that's the, arrangement of the powerhouse. And this is another thing we have not discussed in the while dealing with diagrams. So this is called as EOT crane. So electrically operated overhead traveling crane. So this has to be arranged at the roof of the powerhouse. And these cranes generally are used for installing turbines, installing generators, turbine and generator assemblies, and also for shifting these items for repairs and maintenance. So to make arrangements for repairs and maintenance of all these items. So all these items to be shifted to workshops. So for all these purposes, we have to install a crane at the roof of the powerhouse. So that can be used for installing turbines and generators, and also for shifting the these items for repairs and maintenance. And finally, we have talked about the draft tube in the second diagram. So basically, it is fitted to the outlet of the runner. So it is required only for operating Francis and Kaplan turbines. So negative pressure will be developed only in the case of Francis and Kaplan turbines. So therefore, these draft tubes are only used for operating Francis and Kaplan turbines. And as indicated earlier, no negative pressure will be developed during the operation of the Pelton turbine. So we need not use, draft tube is not required for operating the Pelton turbine, but it is very, very essential for operating the Francis and Kaplan turbines. So this basically draft tube, it will be receiving water coming out of the runner, and it will be removing the negative pressure of the water, and finally it will be discharging the entire quantity of water onto the tail race. So this is the last item. And finally, this exit of the draft tube. So generally, draft tube is also a pipeline. So inlet will be connected to the outlet of the runner. Inlet of the draft tube will be connected to the outlet of the runner. and outlet of the draft tube must be submerged below the level of water in the second reservoir. That means it has to be submerged below the tail water level. Otherwise, air will be entering the draft tube, and again it will be destroying the pressure energy of the liquid. So these are the precautions to be taken while using the draft tube, while installing and using the draft tube. So we have covered all these various topics, various components of the hydroelectric power plant. So I thank you all for attending this session. Now we are closing the session. Thank you so much for attending the session.